Alright, Pablo Strix here, and today's vault video has no vault, but what I am gonna do is I'm gonna run you through what you should do every week from now on, and I'm gonna go through the normal what's up this week stuff as well. So, you get to choose your aid in the Accord again. I chose Emerald Bounty, which is super easy, planting 3 Dream Seeds. Sparks of Life this week, and this one's actually going to stay the whole week, unlike last week when I forgot to do it and didn't get the rep. But it's in Azure Span, so this is where the ganking happens. So be prepared for that. If you want to get the Bloody Token gear and the PvP gear, that's still there. It's 450 veteran stuff, but you can do LFR as well this week. Talk about that in a bit. Rated BGs. I don't know why I closed that. We got rated BGs up. You got the Battleground Blitz up, so I'd do that, which is kind of like a rated BG, but I don't think it counts. And then Honor earned in random battlegrounds, so you can do that. Get your Honor, get your Conquest, and get your PvP stuff if that's your thing. Yeah, Battleground Blitz. So for profession stuff this week in Loam, if you want your Barter Boulders, if you want those, you got ink and gems. Alright, now you can buy skill points with your barter boulders, so that's what that's for. We do have one catalyst charge this week. We won't get our next one till the 28th, so be responsible with it. Time rifts up, they're still rewarding the new item level stuff now. Which adventure is adventure stuff, so it can be upgraded all the way to 450 and converted to old Aberyst tier, which is awesome. I'm glad they did that. I was worried. I was doing a video talking about it's going to be harder to get, and it was wrong in a good way because they did something unprecedented. World Boss is up in Waking Shore, but that's the old one. Same thing with the Zarlek one. But the new World Boss is up and has actually been very nice with loot for once. Alright, the new campaign stuff is up. I'll talk about that a little later. And the Farrakh Assault and Dream Surge are both up in the Azure Span this week. So if you want to get the Farrakh Assault stuff, which awards adventurer stuff, and the Dream Surge also awards adventurer stuff. But remember, the Dream Surge has 415 catch-up gear now, and any old tokens you had for the Dreambound gear has been bumped up, by the way. So if you had any old pieces, like, let's see if I had an old piece on this tune. I do on some other tunes, and they've been upgraded. Now, I came over here because I wanted to show everybody the weeklies here. So there's 3 weeklies that award veteran track gear, which is the same as LFR. So if you're a solo player, these are great for you. One is Worthy Ally, which I can't pick up because I have all that PvP stuff. All right, that's from Keeper Amarin. You got the 5 Dream Seeds. Plant these 5 Dream Seeds, you get some veteran gear and flight stones and supplies. You do your Seed Bloom weekly, which you get from the little centaur that follows around Spruce Crown, Clairel. And there's another weekly, and these actually give you seeds. So the way this works is you get 1 quest for 1 shipment, you get a plump seed, get 250 rep, get some supplies. Then when you do that, put in your shipment, all right, you get another quest for 5. Now, the materials I've been using this week, because the shipment materials actually change week to week. So last week I was using diamonds, but that has since changed. So now my go-to is gems. Now the gem I buy, which is super cheap, is Norse Dorite. So if you wanted to fully complete both, you'd get 150. So that's like 1,000 gold. So you just get that, right? Super easy. This gets you either 750 or 1,000 rep. But since I'm renowned 10, it's gonna get me double that. See, I put in a shipment, put in the gems, bada boom. I get my shipment of goods, turn that in, and this is weekly. And it gets you seeds, so 250 and 250. So it gets you a total of 500 and then a plump seed, which I will do a specific video about seeds, but the way they work is if you plant a plump seed, you can get a mount. You don't have to fill up the one side at all. You can get one of the seed bloom mounts. Same thing with the plump, or not the, giga seed is mounts, the plump seed is pets. All right, now the way the dew works, the Mountain Dew that you put in, that box can also contain a mount. And that and the seed are linked to the rep. So you need to have a seed to get rep in your first 5 seed blooms, all right? But the rep is dictated by having a blue or higher dew. So there you go, there's a little explainer. So yeah, make sure you get that weekly stuff done. If you're trying to grind rep, wait till Thursday. This starts at 10 a.m. It doesn't start at the midnight. It starts Thursday reset. All right, so you gotta wait till after the reset. All right, now let's get into more of the news. So season 3 has started. M plus is going on. I have not done any M plus, but I have done the raid. I am going to comment about the raid, and I don't know what affixes are up this week. So good luck. Also, that means new PvP season, which means new vicious mount. If you want to get the moon beast, the vicious moon beast, start working on that. Got the new tier, all the good stuff. LFR is out. Awesome. First swing actually includes 2 tier pieces, all right, because you actually fight this, you fight the first 2 bosses and then the third to last boss, all right, Smolderon. So little spoiler there, but to queue for LFR you just need 424. Like, look at this, I can already queue. Should be, no, yeah, see, I'm a little bit away. So 424, I do my weeklies and then run LFR. But you don't even need to run LFR for veteran stuff. But there are some good weapons and things and tier, of course, because you can only convert one piece. So there's a Twitch drop going on this week till the 21st. It is the White Riding Camel or something like that. The White Camel. And then all the new quests and cinematics came out, so there's all that to watch if you want to spoil yourself or if you want to play through it and experience it yourself. Have fun with that. I know I will be. And then moving on to the other games, we got Hearthstone came out with the new expansion launch proper. I opened all my packs. I got a bunch of legendaries. You can see what I got. I got 2 signatures. It was great. And that's Showdown in the Badlands, and the event in Hearthstone starts next week. So have fun in that with that if you're a Hearthstone player. They also extended the Rumble. So if you play Warcraft Rumble, you can get a card back in Hearthstone, and it was only going to last for 2 weeks, but they extended it. Hopefully they extend the WoW one. If they do not play Warcraft Rumble, get your pet. This pet right here. Nomelia Gearheart. So get her while you can, unless they extend it, which they should. Diablo had a pet hotfix today. There is been a buff to Lightning Steel. It still only comes from Helltides. Some people were complaining it should come from other sources of Helltides, and I'm like, I kinda want that, but I'm fine with the bump up. And maybe they should make Helltides more consistent. Because I get that they want to have certain bosses be the boss of certain sections of the game. I kind of get that. And then For the blood donation, the blood drive, we've unlocked the second tier, I believe, which gets a mount. So there is a mount, a free mount in Diablo. You just log in, you get it. There you go. And then in Overwatch news, the Roadhog rework happened. So if you like Roadhog, check that out. Or if you like Roadhog and Overwatch, check that out. And yeah, Rumble's still doing its thing. If you're rumbling, have fun with that. I've been playing that. And now, okay, I'm going to do a little mini rant, okay? That's pretty much all the news. If you want to go now, you can. But so the new cinematics came out and everyone's complaining about I didn't get what I want, that I didn't get what I wanted to see. Oh, the story sucked. Oh, bad writing. Oh, boohoo. I get so tired of a person hyping up what they want and then it not being that and then being like, well, you're garbage for not doing exactly what I wanted. Stop it. There's literally people being like, these people should be fired for how they... Shut the fuck up. Just play the game. The game is in a great spot right now. I've been fine with the story. I've been having a good time. I'm following along. Everything makes sense. One minor thing that I would change is the location of something. But boo fucking who that this shit takes place in the fucking expansion we're in. Okay? Boo fucking who. Get over it. You're still playing the game. You're still giving them their money. So either you hate it so much and go, or move on with your day. Alright? Because it feels like, literally it feels like everybody's a critic. And it's like, it's fine to be like, listen, it's fine to be like, I don't like this. Be like, hey, I didn't like this. And then move on. Move the fuck on. But it's like these people consistently, oh this, it's been bad since this. Oh, bye. Please. Like, I just want to mute so much of the Twitter world. It's so ridiculous. But then I wouldn't know what people are talking about. I do like to know what people are talking about. But some of these are just like, can you grow up? Can you please grow up? Please just grow up a little bit. Learn how society works. Get a grip. But that's been my rant. I'm just so freaking tired. Because I'm just having such a good time. And people want to be like, oh, but this, you should be upset. Why do you like this? Sure, you're wrong. Leave me the fuck alone. Stop telling other people that it's got to be bad. You got to hate it. You got to do this. It's just so much rage bait, dude. It's so exhausting. I'm having a good time. I really enjoyed the raid. My guild so far has gotten up to Smolderon. You know, we killed all these bosses in one night, 2 hours. It was good. I'm trying to get better at AUG, dude. I have to really buff specific people in my group to do well. And that's a pain in the butt. I wish it could just be a lot easier for me to be like, hey, I want to target these two people. You know, but I can't. But there it is. So far, I've been enjoying the raid. I've been enjoying this patch. And I'm not going to be venting about this anytime soon. My next rant will be about the dwarves. And that's going to be a fun video. That will be coming out later this week. As far as the rest going on, we'll have to see. Maybe my lore rant will be more about the lore. But my opinions on it, and how I've been enjoying it, and am happy for the conclusion of some of this stuff. I'm looking forward to the new stuff. And hopefully soon we get 10.2.5 stuff, so people can complain about that too! Dragons are literally going to be able to fly, and people are going to be like, but why can't I be a new class? Why can't I wear armor? All the same stuff, you know. Some of that, I wish Drakthir could show more armor, but It's always going to be something. You can't be happy about a thing. That's the thing. You can't be happy about getting a thing. You have to complain about... Yeah, usually it's like, oh, it took them this long. Oh, why didn't it... It's always... You can't ever be happy. You really can't, is what it seems like. But yeah, I'm done. I went on long enough. But that's the weekly. I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye-bye.